Come on now. I win! Ha ha! Oh, I did it. I didn't want to skip it. It took me 4 times with that one. If they get any harder, I'm gonna have to skip it. Because that was just ridiculous. Four times a charm. Got it. New task. Install Ida's new battery. Or Ida's new battery, rather. Are there any evil entities present? I'm not sticking around to find out.
I found out what special quality those kids had. They had exceptionally developed visual perception. Hmm. Visual and aesthetic.
Really?
For them, the shape, color, and the like of surrounding objects was of critical importance. Some things were beautiful in their eyes, others the definition of ugly. And here's the kicker. They were always in consensus.
Here's a kicker, huh?
But it was that very ability that ultimately became their blight. The particulars, however, I still do not know.
Hmm. Interesting. Here's the kicker. I never heard her talk like that before. Does it look more drab out here? Pardon me? Oh, that's her beeping. I'm like, what the hell is that? Got it.
Did you bring the battery?
Here it is. Let's replace it.
Go ahead. But you'll need to switch me off first.
All right.
Here come the shakes again.
Well, no way around that.
Yep. Aww. Shut me down.
See you in a minute.
I feel like entire life is in our hands. Like, what if we just decide to screw it. I'm gonna go move to the city and we'll just leave her like this. I'll leave her off. Okay, so the battery looks like that. And it says battery. Makes sense. Would it be in here? That. Ah. New task. Speak with Ida. Is that bad? That doesn't sound good.
Attacks in one day.
Not good.
I'm breaking records.
Sounds like you're worse off than when we replaced the battery.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Well, did you find out anything?
Yes.
Did you find your number?
My number? Oh, no, not yet. But I did learn what the children were treated for. Remember I told you that the shape of objects was important to them?
I do.
Well, their illness was called morphophobia.
Morphophobia.
Fear of a shape. Or to be more precise, an aversion to it.
Hmm. Morphophobia.
What kind of shape?
The human body. They couldn't stand the sight of a human body.
Really?
That was their disease.
What do you mean that they... couldn't stand it.
It would make them, like, physically ill.
They would literally get sick.
Yeah.
Vomiting at the sight of any person.
That's not good.
Teachers, doctors, passers-by, their own parents. even seeing each other in the mirror.
Huh.
What did they dislike so much about the human body?
We never did find the answer. The children weren't able to articulate their feelings. First of all, they were really young. And secondly, they were unable to communicate at all with anyone. Any attempt at communication caused suffering and psychogenic vomiting.
Oh, sheesh.
What an unusual disease.
Yes, which is why the treatment was likewise unusual. Now I know the purpose behind those strange activities. Playing with cubes, collecting parts, and so on.
So they liked those shapes.
So why were they assembling an embody on stage?
To cultivate in the children a positive association with the sight of a human body. They were using those bits to independently assemble a fairy tale character. A positive character. And thanks to their efforts, a young woman would take the stage. The defender of beauty, protecting a blossoming garden from a wicked witch.
Huh.
The witch symbolized ugliness?
Evidently. Beauty would triumph over ugliness, and the children rejoiced at their involvement in bringing about a happy end. Bit by bit, their repulsion toward the human body was thus dislodged from their psyches, replaced by a new mindset, which filled the human body with beauty and goodness.
I can't help but notice the parallels here between the kids and everyone else who's like obsessed with beauty and has to collect the most, you know, beautiful flower, you know, possible in the 80th percentile, 90th percentile. Maybe their illness spread.
I see. And the cubes? What was their purpose?
The cubes have an extremely simple shape.
Right.
Playing in the pavilions blunted the kids' excessive sensitivity. Their psyches were being simplified so as to start sewing in them trivial categories. Good and evil, beauty and ugliness. Because their perception developed in an anomalous manner, the kids saw the world of shapes very differently, in a way that grown-ups could never understand. And there was no other way to save their lives other than to make them simpler.
Hmm. Well, I pretty much understand it. I guess he doesn't.
I'm still having trouble understanding.
Hold on.
Holding?
Meyer. Inhibish. My name is Ida Meyer.
Ida Meyer.
You remembered?
I found a journal. It contains my data. Here. Ida Meyer, age 26, city of Geneva. My personal number. And a date. August 15th, 2058. What year is it, by the way?
Right. So she has her personal number.
76.
Whoa. So, I'm a psychologist from Geneva, and I've been lying in Mongolian soil for 18 years.
In a candy box. And not in soil, but in sand.
Very well, in sand. And now I'm in a flower vase, trying to verify my number. Only, damn it.
What?
It's not working. The network interface. I can't get online.
I guess the vase doesn't integrate with the web.
Anibish, there's another network terminal underneath the TV. It's functional, only without power.
Well, that.
If you can power it up, I'll be able to get online.
Help me understand something.
What?
How did the kids react to seeing a mechanical body?
The same way as an organic one. They puked.
They puked. You notice she's using like more and more, I don't know, not slang, but casual speak. Instead of saying they vomited, they puked. And before she said, here's the kicker. I don't know if it's making something out of nothing, but it could be something.
But then how did they interact with the staff?
Their bouts of morphophobia were suppressed.
Ill manner.
The complex was equipped with these emitters. I don't know how they worked, but exposure to them enabled the kids to communicate with the staff as well as among themselves.
Emitters.
Got it.
Alright, so I'm gonna tell her.
Did you power up the terminal?
Not yet.
Not yet.
Alright, so... Help Ida connect to the web. Run power to the network terminal underneath the TV, then turn it on. Put the batteries in the box under the awning. Put the batteries. Yeah, this is what we're talking about, right? This is the TV. Alright. The batteries in the box. In the box. What awning? Under the awning. It's written strange, isn't it? Put the batteries in the box under the awning. Nothing in there. Batteries in the box. Right. I guess this awning? You could just tell me to put it here. Or maybe they mean the box is under an awning. An awning, which would be outside, right? It's not this. I mean, it looks like a battery, though. Not that. I'm not sure if it is a box outside. We can't open that box. Hold up. Yeah. I don't have the power to open boxes. Unless it's this. This is another one. A bunch of batteries. I guess there's not the right kind of batteries. I mean, is what? This isn't an awning, right? Huh. Substance out of nothing. Oh, did I read that? A curious physical phenomenon is being observed during experiments of synchronizing neurochips with DNA copies. A condensate of unknown substance has been forming inside fully airproof sections of the resonating mechanism. Data gleaned from its chemical properties is sure to send shockwaves across the scientific community, researchers claim. Anything else? There's another one of those batteries, though. I can take those, which makes me think that it's something worth taking. Huh. Let's see that. Cash voucher. Phytocopy covers synthetic sterilant, thermal processing fluid, charm store, Bayang Kongor HQ market. Thank you for your business. Anubish, please tell Tabaha that I won't be changing bodies yet. No need. They fixed up my sight and I'm grateful. I don't ask anything else of Providence. My role is a modest one. Who wrote that? Cash voucher for fuel cell and an Around and Around magazine. Coins. One unit, two units. By the time the evacuation squad arrived, he was spinning at 200 revolutions per minute. The poor soul was secured and forced into a reboot. Citizens of medium and high quotients, remember, by replacing your body, you give the whole world hope. To fill out the ranks of humanity's rescuers, contact your local mirror transfer center. Still racking my brain to try to figure out what they mean by the box under the awning. Because there really aren't boxes. I don't suppose
you power up the terminal?
Help me understand something.
What?
How did the kids react to seeing a mechanical body?
The same way as an organic.
But then how did they interact with the staff?
Their bouts of more.
Got it.
Did you power up the terminal?
Should I say
not yet.
I found a remote. Okay, we might need that as well. Anything else under there? Another more seven covers per pack. The box is wired up. Oh, this box? Box is wired up. Ah! So this is an awning. I don't think of this as an awning, but whatever. Now the box is wired up with batteries. Install a solar battery on the Yurt's roof. Solar battery or solar panel? I remember seeing this thing. Hopefully it may mean solar panel. This way I can just use this. Where would I put that thing? Here? Well, it kind of blocks off the light then, doesn't it? Maybe here. I don't know. We'll find out. Maybe. Where would I put such a thing? Ah! Why would someone even take that down? Use the remote to switch on a terminal, which I found looking for the freaking box under an awning. We're almost there, baby.
The reason is both simple and evident. Simultaneous existence of two copies of the same person gives rise to problems we are not prepared to tackle, as clearly demonstrated by the sorrowful experience of the recent past. For now, strict prohibition on duplication and forced deactivation of existing duplicates remain the only solution to the situation. Deactivated neurocopies are retired into secure storage facilities for likely reactivation in the future, when a legitimate solution is found. This is one of the cases when...
Speak to Ida. Yeah, it's smoking. I don't have good news.
Ida, our terminal burned down.
Ida, sorry.
I know, but I managed to check the number in time.
Oh, good.
You did? So what's the news? Are you going home?
The news is bad. I no longer have Original's right. There's nowhere for me to go.
Original's right. So somebody else... moved into this body, or is planning on moving into this body? I get confused.
Huh. Why?
I was restored. 3 years ago, Ida Meyer was confirmed dead and restored from a reserve neurocopy. She currently lives somewhere in Geneva.
Oh. So there's another Ida out there.
We don't seem to have much luck. How did she die?
It says here, died in a disparatoxin emission in 2058.
But they restored her from a copy. So, I guess the copy has the originals, right? Because it was restored first, before you were awoken. I'm guessing.
This means you are now a duplicate?
Correct. My very existence is illegal.
Well, don't fret. We'll improvise.
Improvise?
Sure. We'll find you a normal body with legs.
With legs? And then what?
A normal body? Do you mean a biological body, not artificial?
Then we'll live our lives.
How do you do that?
Selling flowers.
Anibish, listen. When my battery runs out, I want you to put my flowers into secure warranty. I mean, into a glass cell, yes? That is a secure evacuation. I understand.
Are you having panic attack? Because I just gave you a new battery and everything.
What?
What I mean is, please put my neurochip in a cell which... Anibish, into a camera of tights, or a camera of dreams.
What? A camera of what?
What's with your voice?
I don't know.
Yeah, a camera of tides?
A camera of tides? What are you talking about?
I'm malfunctioning somehow. My thoughts are out of order.
Okay.
But I think it's over.
You need repairs.
I don't need anything, Inhibish. I'll be put to sleep soon. Disconnected. And for a long while, I bet.
For a long while? It would be forever, I would think.
So, you've decided?
Yes. That is my decision.
So you wake up and go right back to sleep. Got it.
More like, wake up, get totally confused. And go back to sleep.
What are you confused about?
The explosion, for one thing. I haven't a clue how I'm connected to it.
You got caught in an emission. That's just bad luck.
No, Inhibish, it's not that simple. I found another mention of my name, here, in the database, in the search history. Somebody was searching for information about me.
Silly question. What's so strange about that? Who would be searching for information about her? I'm wondering if her other self, who has the originals right, could be the one searching. If she's aware of her existence? I don't know.
So what? What's so strange about that?
The fact that it was the only query for my name in the entire search history. Made 20 minutes before the explosion.
Huh.
Who made the query?
Ida.
A man named Mark.
Oh.
Mark Darren. He's listed as transfer operator. The explosion happened on his shift. There's even a recording of it. And also... How curious.
What?
Going by the recording, there was an equipment breakdown not long before the explosion, at around the same time the query was made. Yes, I want to know what happened there.
What kind of a recording is it?
A report. It was saved automatically. It mentions some kind of a malfunction that, because it wasn't corrected in time, forced a modification in the transfer procedure. And no, I don't know the nature of the modification. I haven't yet figured it out.
Modification? Well, if you've been modified enough so that you're different from Ida, the other Ida, then you could live on, right?
Why do you even care? Is that really important now?
It is to me. Because aside from these fragments of the past, I have more fragments of the past than... I mean...
Ida. Hey.
It happened again. I'm getting worse.
I'll repeat. You need repairs.
You need to know the cause of the problem before you can correct it, which I do not.
Your voice is changing.
If only it were just the voice. I'm at a loss. The reasons could be many. Could be my synchronizer is on the fritz. I've heard of cases when the neurochip malfunctioned due to a deteriorating link with the DNA. Either that or my neurocopy is failing. But if that's the case...
See, little things like that on the fritz. She's been using total, like, robot kind of analytical, logical type of speech pattern. But every once in a while, something like on the fritz comes out.
What then?
Nothing. Let's just hope it's the synchronizer.
Let's. Then we'll replace it with a new one.
Sure. There's a new one here in a small distance close.
Huh. Okay.
Give me the pavilion number. I'll go and get it.
Is in six rooms soft?
Hoping it's six that we're looking for. She's didn't mess something up.
Got it. And, don't go crazy just yet. Try.
Try?
Yes.
Did you bring it?
Not yet.
Can't ask her for more information. So what do we have to do? Ida is losing her ability to communicate. Perhaps replacing her synchronizer will fix the problem. Acquire a new synchronizer. Search the sixth pavilion. Alright, be more blocks, I guess, guys. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode when we search the sixth pavilion. Endure. And enduring? Grow strong.